guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll be sharing a matcha cheese tart that I made to bring to my friend's place on Boxing Day. We were having a summer seafood themed dinner and I just wanted to bring something along for dessert, and I love no-bake cheesecakes, so I decided to make this easy no-bake matcha cheese tart. When I went to the store to get ingredients, this lactose-free cream cheese was on sale that supposedly still has a fresh, creamy taste, so I decided to give it a go and see how it is. Of course, you could use regular cream cheese also. Alright, so without further ado, let's get into this easy, no-bake matcha cheese tart. I made this for an 11-inch tart pan, but I'll also give you the general ratios to work with if you have a smaller or larger pan. It came out really nice and matcha flavored with a crumbly base to match. Make this the night before, or at the very least, allow half a day in the fridge before you serve it so that it's nicely set. Okay, for the base, I love no-bake bases made out of these McVitie's digestive biscuits. I didn't want to use any butter, so I used solid coconut oil instead. Just make sure your coconut oil is at least semi-solid, because the firmer texture will help you when you're molding the base into the pan. I used a total of 16 biscuits to fill my pan, which I blended in two parts because my processor is tiny, but if you have a smaller or larger tart pan, the ratio of coconut oil is 1 tablespoon of coconut oil for every 4 biscuits. So you can start off with a lower or higher multiple of 4 combination to suit your size. And, you know, everyone has a different preference for a thicker or thinner base, so adjust accordingly for your own preference. Anyways, I put the biscuits into a blender to pulse and break it up a bit first. Then, in total, for 16 biscuits, I added 4 tablespoons of solid coconut oil. Blitz it up again and watch it mix up with the biscuits in the blender. If it's not mixing evenly, stop and stir the mixture with a spoon and then pulse again. You'll know it's a good base batter once it starts to look kind of like wet sand. Once you have your base, pour it out in your tart pan and start spreading it out and pressing it into the base. Press it up into the sides also. Once you have it all spread out nicely, pop this into the fridge to firm up for at least 15 to 20 minutes while we're making the filling. For the filling, in a large mixing bowl, I added in 375 grams of cream cheese, 260 grams of condensed milk. And I added 2 teaspoons of vanilla essence. Now, to give my mixer a hand in making it smooth, I just cut up the cream cheese block, then getting out my hand mixer and beat it all up. Make sure you get any lumps with the beater so it's nice and smooth. Once the mixture is smooth, I found that if I kept beating it, it got slightly aerated, so it was nice and fluffy. Then I added a total of 5 teaspoons of pure matcha powder. I'm using my favorite, Matcha Maiden, to get a nice matcha flavor. Guys, just remember that these are leveled teaspoons, not heaped ones. If you're using heaped teaspoons, you could be adding double or more than what you intended to. I added these in 1 teaspoon at a time and blended them in to make sure it was nice and evenly distributed throughout the filling. It made a really pretty pastel green color. Now that the filling was ready, I got the base out of the fridge, which was nice and firm by then. And I just started pouring the filling mixture in and spreading it all out, making sure to fill up to the edges of the tart. Once the filling is all in, I just gently shook it out so that the surface got nice and level. Now, important part here, make your tart the night before you intend to serve it, or at least give it half a day in the fridge to allow it to set. I made this literally just a couple of hours before we headed to my friend's place, and the filling hadn't fully set yet. It still tasted good, but it would have been better if the filling was fully set. Finally, to decorate the tart, I just added a few slices of lemon on the side, dusted on some stevia for that powdered look, and I added on some lemon thyme leaves from my herb garden to finish it off. And that's a super easy, no-bake matcha cheese tart. You could also make them as little individual matcha cheese tartlets or as a cheesecake by using a cake pan instead. I also made a seafood pasta with a Greek yogurt dressing to bring along to the dinner. The cheese tart didn't fit in my cake carrier, so I wrapped the top with some aluminium foil to get it safely to my friend's place. Dinner was a delicious seafood spread with massive prawns, an awesome seafood paella, and a side of Caesar salad. It was so good to catch up and feast together with these friends. Alright, I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did enjoy it, please like, share, comment, and subscribe because it really helps to support my channel. And I'll be back next week with another video. Also, you could check out my Instagram over here for more content. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!